It's time we finally introduce Pandas. It's one of the most important libraries in the Python data science stack. We saw NumPy, we understood why it was so important because it was, again, a fundamental library, NumPy. But Pandas is, to be honest, that library that you will be spending the most time as a data scientist with. Like, seriously, 90% of your time as a Python data scientist will be dedicated to using Pandas. Pandas is used for multiple things in the day-to-day work as data scientist or data analyst. For example, gathering data, right? So pulling data, Pandas is gonna be that library we're gonna use to pull data from our database or read files or even scrape websites. It has a simple function that lets us read directly from a web page. So that's a pulling process that we actually described in our data science journey in one of the first videos we did in this series. It will also be useful for the whole data cleaning process and identifying missing values, invalid values, etc. It has a couple of very simple methods for the whole data cleaning process. Then we have these data wrangling, data munging phase that includes multiple things. To be honest, there are like 100 methods that will be used there, from concatenating different structures to joining things, to splitting things, etc. And finally, it will also give you access to tools like visualizations and also plays very nicely with some machine learning tools. And that's, of course, all the things we will be including throughout the course. Pandas is a very popular package. We have actually this image that shows how much it has grown in the past years. And again, it has become this fundamental library in the data science space. There is no single day that we as data scientists, we don't use Pandas. It's a very popular and powerful library out there. I recommend you to check the official website and the documentation. To be honest, it lacks a little bit of simple access. It's still very technical. You know, it's like it has list links here and all the releases. But again, it's worth investing the time of looking into Pandas and the documentation under Pandas. Finally, I want to point out that the creator of Pandas, Wes McKinney, is a very interesting person in the open source space. And he created Pandas out of a financial background while working with R. And that's why Pandas has multiple drives, multiple concepts from other successful libraries or languages or packages, like, for example, R. So Pandas, again, is a very thoughtful and an important library. And it is something serious. It's something that actually we will need to dedicate multiple videos, and a lot of our course will be based on the usage of Pandas. It's fundamental for data analysis and the whole data science stack. So this notebook right here has more information. I encourage you to take a look. At the end, we are introducing a couple of technical details of the language, of the library. And these are the things we'll be exploring in the following video. So right here, there's a very, very quick introduction to the two main data structures that Pandas has. Remember when we talked about NumPy, we said that NumPy was a fundamental data science library, but it was also very simple. It had NumPy arrays, and it also had a bunch of numeric types. And that was it. The same thing happens with Pandas. It's a very, very, very powerful library, but still, it's also very simple to manage. It has only two fundamental data structures, a Pandas series and a Pandas DataFrame, that, again, we're gonna talk in length in the following videos. It drives all the data types from NumPy. So for example, the numbers you're going to have in a data frame or series in Pandas will be the same data types as we use in NumPy. And on top of these two data structures, series and the data frame, it will add all the methods that we need to manage the data. So at any point, you will be transforming any data that you have either into a series or a data frame. The fundamental difference between the series and the data frame is that a series looks a little bit more as a columnar, as a vertical, if you want, vector, right? It's just like a column vector in NumPy or just linear algebra. So it's kind of a one-dimensional data structure. That is not entirely true. We will see that actually we can squeeze multiple dimensions in either a series or a data frame once we reach the more advanced stages of this course. But at the beginning, what we can say is that a series looks a little bit more as a column vector, as a one-dimensional data structure. In the other hand, the data frame, which is arguably the most popular data structure in Pandas, the one we use more often, the data frame is actually resembles more tabular data, what you know as a simple Excel spreadsheet. That's gonna be it. The data frame, what it's gonna be, is gonna be a combination of multiple columns that simulate, or if you want, encode multiple features of your data, right? And actually internally, these columns will be represented as a series. So this is your data, which row per row includes multiple samples of the data. So we can say multiple players, multiple users, multiple, if we are dealing with stock prices, the prices for each day or each minute, etc. So we have multiple samples of our data in a row basis. And again, each column, it's encoding multiple features of your data. In this case, we have players and we have the name, the team, the number, etc., etc., etc. Again, as I told you, each column will be actually encoded as a series. So each column of a data frame will be a series. So that's why these two data structures, again, Pandas is a simple library, just two data structures, but these two are very related and will be usually coming back and forth from series to data frames and from data frames to series. So for example, once you need to zoom in a data frame and you need to just look at one feature, for example, name or number, you will be dealing with a series. And sometimes operations on series will result in a data frame when you're splitting series or when you're adding more dimensions, etc. And the rest of this notebook contains, again, a couple of examples, an example of a series. Once you create a series, what you will see is that Jupyter notebooks will display them in this tabular, very neat format. So it like kind of looks like HTML, like an HTML table. Internally, again, it's all Python code. This is not something, once you have your scripts or your programs deployed into production, this no longer happens. But again, for the purpose of development, a series will have these, again, these tabular, the series and the data frame, they will have this simple, like pretty HTML format. And again, this is a series, just one column, and a data frame, multiple columns, is shown right here. So I encourage you to pull this lecture and start playing around with them and take a look at them, especially at the beginning when sometimes it's confusing what is a series and what is a data frame, etc. We actually have an example that is pulling data from an external file. So we have this CSV file that I will open here on the side. And we are actually pulling these CSV data with just one simple method from Pandas, which is read_csv. Again, we have details for all of this later. But what we want to show you here is that how simple it's going to be to, for example, plot something. So the whole Pandas interface will actually let you also, in this case, plot things and access multiple things that are, to be honest, a little bit at the outside of the scope of Pandas. But again, it plays nicely with other libraries, in this case, with matplotlib, another library that we have to talk about in this course. So again, we have multiple examples. Here you have a couple of how to draw Bollinger Bands on just, you know, the Bitcoin price. And if you want more details, we actually have a blog post on that includes a little bit more details, right, about it. But again, this is a nice notebook, so you can see in just, you know, a very quick overview of the whole Pandas library. And from here, we're starting, and we're having more than 30 videos that are just about Pandas. details of Pandas for data cleaning, for data wrangling, for reading data from multiple sources, reading data from JSON files, CSVs, database, scraping data, etc. So let's start our journey about Pandas. And remember, it's going to be a fundamental library from now on. It's something you're going to use all the time, so it's worth the investment.